What's up? This is Squire2448 with a Farming Simulator 17 video. Today we'll be doing some fire rescue and we'll be using the new Chief truck and fire truck, but we already do have a fire call for a garage building on fire. So let's hop in here. We'll turn the LED lights on and we'll only be using the sirens at intersections. That way all the other drivers know that we are going through the intersection. So we'll just be turning it on now and actually probably just keep it on as we race over to the fire station, which I believe is just around the corner. So we actually went a little bit too far, but that's fine since we do have to kind of rush over there and we are driving pretty fast. So you guys can see that there's a lot of black smoke in the air, so we have to get over there as soon as we possibly can. We got this turned off. We are not even going to be closing the garage door. We'll just have to rush out. We'll probably close it when we get back. We'll hop in this Ford, and I mean, this is an older Ford, but it still does the job for us. We'll pull out here, and we only have some giant air horns on this. We'll just use that. And take a look at that, guys. Now we can see the fire. It looks like it's just this corner of the building. So we'll pull in right here, and the main thing we need to do is stop the fire from spreading if it was to spread. So we'll get the fire hose out and take a look at that, guys. We'll pretty much just kind of attack it from this side so we do not have to worry. Now these fires do take a very long time for us to put it out, but we mainly also have to make sure that the building and everything like that is not going to create a larger fire. But garage buildings usually do have a lot of things inside, maybe vehicles, which have gas and a lot of different types of fluids. So we do have to be very careful for any extra fires. And if you guys would like me to do more fire rescue videos, let me know what types of fires we should be putting out every week, because I think that this is a great series and I really do enjoy doing it, and a lot of you guys really do enjoy it. So it looks like it's going up to that balcony now. I'm pretty much spraying it down as good as I possibly can, but I'm not really sure. I mean, this is just a giant fire, so we just have to be pretty careful. Wow, look at that. It's all the way up there. And I mean, it's getting even warmer, so we'll kind of get lower to the ground, and this is pretty challenging, but I did like using that Chief truck to get to the fire station. That was very fast. We did go an extra street, but we did make it back in time, and I mean, wow, this fire is just going to take us just a little bit longer, so we'll kind of walk over here as close as we can. We'll spray down that garage door, but we can't even see it. We'll come back over here, and now we'll actually kind of increase the water gallon. So we'll come over here. Looks like we did that. And I really do like to role play out all of these fire rescue videos as much as we possibly can. But maybe we could do some GTA 5 fire rescue. I think that'll be a pretty epic series with some pretty awesome fire vehicles. So let me know, guys, should we do one of those? But it looks like this fire is almost out. So we'll just do a little bit more. Awesome, so take a look at that. Now we only have ashes left, and the majority of the flames did go away, which was good. So I think that's going to be it for this call. So we'll walk back over here. We'll be putting the hose away, and usually we'll get the hose off these trucks, but we do have to use this for it. But we'll hop back in the truck now, and we'll just kind of make our way back over to the station and wait for another call. But usually when you do back into the station, also you get to use the LED lights, which is also a pretty cool feature. So we'll turn back and we'll head over there. And I think also while we are back here at the station, I think it would be pretty cool to park the Chief truck in the front of the station, having all the vehicles here. But actually, I'm thinking we'll turn these lights on, and we'll probably just leave this right outside here and wait for the next one. So we'll back this in here, and we'll go get that Chief vehicle and park it right next to it. But we might need to use those fire engines that we do have inside, which are pretty large. But we'll wait to see if the fire calls require those. We'll pull out here, and like I was saying, we'll just be parking it right over here on the corner. So we'll just turn our lights on just to make it easier to back in, and usually fire departments will do this. We'll just back in here. That's actually pretty good how it is. So we'll just wait for the next call. The next call just came in. It is a truck on fire that hit a tree. So we'll be taking this old Ford truck. So we'll hop inside. We'll turn it on. We'll start up the LED lights on it, which are pretty nice upgrades. And we'll be making our way over as fast as we possibly can. We'll be using the nice air horn. And I mean, it's a small fire, but it is also a tree on fire since it did hit it. And take a look at that. We have to get over here before a big brush fire happens. We need to be very careful. It looks like a brush fire is starting to happen, so we'll probably just pull up right here. It looks like we are a pretty safe distance away. We'll get the hose out really fast, and there's a lot of smoke coming from this, and it looks like now it's kind of spread to the brush area, so we'll kind of go just about here, keeping our distance. And it looks like that is like an old pickup truck, so something mechanically might have happened to cause it to go into this tree, but hopefully this tree does not catch on fire. I am kind of giving the tree a lot of water so that it will not catch on fire, keep making sure that we will not have the fire spread. And I would like to thank you all for the continued support on the daily content. I really do enjoy doing these farming sim videos. These are a lot of fun, and they are just overall pretty interesting to do, especially fire rescue with all these very cool fire trucks that we do have. So it looks like this fire is just about almost done. We are now just kind of putting a lot of water on the truck, stopping that, and just a lot of water on the tree and at the main start. But it looked like this was a brush fire, car fire that turned into a brush fire. So, I mean, that's not the best situation. We do have it under control, so I will put out the rest of this fire. All right, it looks like the fire is out after a while putting it out. So we'll go back, put the hose away, and now we'll kind of let the tow truck company take that vehicle away. We'll hop back in this fire truck here. We'll turn the lights off, and we'll be heading back to the fire station. And I think now that we might have to use the other engines today. So we'll just back this all the way into this station so that it's not left outside if we do go to another call. But hopefully we get to use that ladder truck or even the engine truck, because I mean, those are pretty awesome large vehicles. But I mean, this truck has a very awesome inside view for how old it is. So it looks like we are back here at the station. We'll be turning on our lights here, and I'm not sure if these are LED lights since it's an old vehicle, but it looks like it has a newer light bar. So we'll just back this in all the way, turn the lights off, and wait for the next call. Alright guys, we just got another call. It is for the country club. The back of the building is on fire, so we'll be taking the hook and ladder truck, the very large one. So we'll hop on the inside here, and we'll kind of make our way over there. And this truck does not have working LED lights, so we will just be pretty much using the air horn on this one. But I am working on it. Wow, we could already see the fire in the distance. Alright guys, so it looks like we are just about here, and this looks to be the largest fire of the day, and this will be pretty dangerous for us. And it looks like actually the fire isn't that, looks like we probably won't be using the ladder just yet. So we'll hop on the hose really fast, and let's see if we could just put out the fire at the bottom, because it looks like it started over here and it's kind of climbing up the side of the building. So we'll just kind of continue to put out this fire over here. And this fire truck that we are using does not have a functioning ladder. And if you guys do know of any good fire trucks in FS17, let me know and we'll definitely put them to use. But it looks like it's pretty much spreading over to the balconies, a very large fire. So we do have to be pretty careful. Wow, there's a lot of pops, and it's even spreading over here. So this is a very dangerous fire. We have to keep our distance. Alright guys, so it looks like I got this fire put out here. I'm just putting a little bit more water where the fire just started out. But we'll be putting the hose back over here, and we'll be hopping back in the ladder truck. And I mean, this is one epic truck. I actually did convert this from FS15. So we'll be kind of backing up, turning around in the parking lot. And I think when we get back to the fire station, since that was the last call of the day for us, we'll be washing down all of the vehicles. Then we'll take the chief truck and head back to the house. But overall, this ladder truck got us to the scene very fast. And that's perfect because we need to respond fast, but also safely. So the next thing for us to do is to do a few modding videos, adding LED lights to these vehicles. So we're just gonna pull in here, back up, and I'm thinking that we'll probably only wash this one, and if the hose does reach all the way over there, we'll be washing the other one. We'll get this hose, and we'll be washing it out. And usually at the end of the day, or at the end of the weekday, we'll be washing off all the trucks, making sure that they are kept clean and up to date so that they could put out the next fire. So we got this side of the fire truck done. It looks like we'll do the front, and I'm not sure if the hose will reach over there. So we'll actually have to get another pressure washer for that side. So we'll just probably wash this. So it looks like this one is washed. We'll just back this in and we'll close up all of the doors and head back. But overall, today was very successful. We put out 3 different types of fires. We had a car fire that turned into a brush fire. We had a garage building on fire, and we had one of the most epic fires of all time at the country club. It's a very large facility over there, so I mean, we had to get over there fast, and we put it out, so that's good. So we're just gonna make our way back. The house is just around the corner. It's very efficient, and it's a very fast way to go to the station, especially with the house close by. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's fire rescue video. Let me know down below if you do have any cool fire trucks or fire call ideas for me. Thanks for watching, and subscribe for more.